As an inventor, we should try to strike the bullseye at one arrow if you can. But should you fail, it's okay. You try again. I had only Form 5 education. I left school when I was 16 years old. So one day I wanted to make a rubber stamp job. I went to the shop, the bookstore. He told me that it takes 1 week to make a job. So if I can make a machine which can produce rubber stamps within half an hour, I think that's something I can sell. When I started invention back in 1990s, the first thing they tell me was, oh, it cannot be done. Better get a day job. Even my family was concerned whether I can make a living or not. But I believe it can be done. My polychrome machine was a great success. It feels great, isn't it, to see that the machine is now used in all the stationery shops, even in America or Russia, you know, even the whole world. So that inspired me to come up with other inventions. To design something out of nothing is not easy. I think success of an invention is basically you must try. If you don't try, you never know. My latest invention, which I developed last year, to enable the blind man to use a smartphone, a screen, to send text as fast as you. Most people think it's impossible. So what I did, I developed apps. We're using Braille. As you know, the Braille, there's only 6 dots. With the 6 dots, they're able to construct all the ABC they need. Then you ask, how would the blind know where are the buttons? You know the answer? It's just a sticker, a film, which you paste on top of the screen where you actually puncture the holes according to the buttons where the dollar is. So the blind man can actually feel the holes, he knows where the buttons. That will enable him to type whatever he wants. A lot of people tried to use the voice technology, but it is never accurate. But text to voice is easy. So my technology is that they can type, they send to you, you receive in text. If you reply to them, even in voice. And that invention actually won the APITA Award for 2014. I would hope that I'll be remembered for the vision touch. I think this is the only one. It's not just software, it's a whole method enable the blind. Because all for years and years, the blind have been deprived of the technology that things are. So one day, if all the blind in the world using this phone, I will have a name for it. Young inventors should be bold, right? They should believe in themselves. It's not difficult. They should start with small, reachable fruit. It's not about low-hanging fruit or high-hanging fruit. It's about what you can reach. I don't believe I have any regrets. It's something, if I will live my life again, I'll do it again.